Hello and welcome back to the channel. So in the previous lecture we have seen what is RDD and how to create one. But now let's move over to the another core concept in Spark, which is data frames. So this lecture will discuss what is data frame, what is its significant and how to create one. And after that we'll jump on to the interesting part, which is we will just make a PySpark script and run it on top of Hadoop, which you guys are all waiting for. So without further ado, let's get into it. So you might ask, what really is a data frame? So data frame is nothing but an immutable distributed collection of data. So immutable means we cannot change it, but we can create another data frame by using the existing one. So this immutable collection of data is organized in a row columnar fashion, which is similar to a table in relational database. So if you know the different RDBMS, the data is basically stored in the row format and it has some structured assigned to it while creating a table. So which means you can run different SQL queries on top of the data. So once you create a data frame, you can create a temporary view, and on top of it, we can take an advantage of Spark SQL API and we can submit SQL queries on top of that data. It's cool, isn't it? But it has more advantages that you may think of. So why there is a need of data frame? We have an RDD, right? But if you're using different languages other than Scala, like Python or R, this performance is significantly reduced because of the communication overhead between the JVM and Py4j. I know this will bother you, but simply said, when you talk about RDD, the performance will be way more deteriorated if you use the languages rather than Scala, because Spark is basically written in Scala, so it will have the performance benefit and it will not have any overhead due to communication. But if you talk about data frames, it has significant improvement in the performance and it will not have that burden of communication between the Py4j and the JVM objects. Let's talk about it in a graphical manner. So as you can see in this figure, if you use a data frame, the performance is similar across all the languages. So even if you use Spark SQL or R, Python or Java or Scala, the performance is similar. But you talk about RDD, there is a significant reduction in the performance if you use Python instead of Java or Scala. So typically this slowdown in query performance was due to the communication overhead that we just talked about. So with data frames, it not only has a significant improvement in the performance, but there is now parity between the performance among all the languages such as Python, Scala, SQL and R. So this all thanks to the data frame. But wait a minute, let's jump into how to create a data frame, because that's the most interesting part, right? So now let's talk about how to create a data frame. So you can create data frame by different ways. Either you can create data frame on top of awesome JSON data, or else some comma separated file or any other structure. Or else if you have a file stored in your system, you can just create a data frame on top of it. Just let sure that file should have some structure to automatically apply the schema. Or else you can programmatically define the schema as well. So whatever the column, data types you need and also the delimiters which you need, you can programmatically assign that. But that's a different topic. Now let's talk about how to create a data frame. So in this example, we have imported the PySpark and we have imported Spark session from the PySpark.sql, as we're using Python for this example, as Python is more understandable and easily readable. So as we discussed in the previous lecture, the first step of every Spark application is creating a Spark session. So here on the third line, we have created a Spark session using the builder method, and also we have given some app name and we are using get or create method. So it will just get the existing session or just create a one if it doesn't find it. And on the next line, we have just sample data to it. So we have the data. So on top of it, we can create a data frame because this data has some structure, right? So this will be our data and the column object will be the schema. So schema means nothing but the column names, or we can say the field names. So here is the statement of creating a data frame. So all you have to do is you have to call out the Spark session by using the Spark, as we have defined Spark here. So spark.createDataFrame. So just look out for the capitalization here, and in bracket just give the data and schema. So our data will be nothing but the sample data, And the schema is nothing but the columns, which we just given here. So that's it. You have created a data frame. It's very simple. And also, there are some different actions which you can do on top of this data frame. So the first one is print schema. So as the name suggests, it will just give you the metadata of the created data frame. So it will give you the column names and the data type which can go into the specific field. And this show command, I hope you already know that show will display our data frame on the console. We will get more familiar with it when we start executing our PySpark scripts. But for the basics, you can create data frame on top of any type of data, but it should be semi structure or structure type. But wait a minute, if you have some files saved on your PC, like for say if it is a CSV file or a parquet file or any type of structured or semi structured file, or you can say JSON file. So you may ask how to create a data frame on top of it. It's very simple. So let's talk about it. So now let's discuss about creating a data frame on top of a file. So as usual, our first step will be to import the required modules and packages. So first we'll import the Spark session from PySpark.sql, then functions, and then the types. So this type is specifically when you are programmatically applying any schema on top of your data frame, then it is useful. Otherwise, just ignore it. Then as usual, we will create a Spark session, which is entry point of every Spark application. And then we are creating a data frame. So what we are doing is we are creating a data frame and we are using spark.read, because here we are reading the file from any location. So either it could be your local system, or either it could be Amazon S3 bucket or HDFS. So you already know in this Hadoop tutorial, we will be dealing with HDFS as a storage layer. So here, according to that, it will read the data from the HDFS path. And here we are providing different options such as header, info schema, and path. So let's talk about them one by one. So first one will be the format. So what format your file is, that you have to specify here. So as you can see, we are dealing with a CSV file, which is nothing but a comma separated file. So here we have given CSV and we have given dot slash. So this is just mean that this is a single line, but it acts as a separator, which will make your code more readable. So on the next line, the second option is header. So the header is nothing but the option. So if your CSV file has the header, which is nothing but a field names, then you have to provide true. Otherwise, you have to provide false and then manually give the headers to your data frame. The third option is info schema. So it nothing but automatically generates the schema as per the structure of the file or the type of data that you're handling. So we have just given true here, because our file is CSV and in the structured format as well. And the last one is the most important, which is the path. So where the file resides. So here my file was stored in a C drive. Here is the path of the file where it is stored. So it is nothing but a fake friends header or CSV file. So I was just dealing with this data when I was practicing PySpark in my local PC. But in our example, this path will probably be the HDFS path. So that will be going to C from the upcoming sessions. And then after all this read operation, you have to provide a load for loading that data into your data frame. So this is the statement of creating a data frame as per the data that you're handling. So here, this is the example of CSV, but you can put different file formats here. So if your file is nothing but a JSON file, then you can give JSON, or else you can give Parquet. So Spark has capability of to work with different types of data files. And then as usual, what we're doing is we are printing the schema on the console, which will give us the metadata of that data frame, and the show method will show the data inside your data frame on to the console, which is similar to the previous example we have just talked about. So this was all about what is data frame and the significance of data frame. Then we have discussed the performance improvements, and also we have seen how to create a data frame. So either it could be on some simple data such as JSON data or some CSV data, anything. And also how to create a data frame on top of some file which is stored in different storage types. So here I hope You got a clear idea what is data frame, its significance, and how to create it. So just enough talking. From the next lecture, I'll assure you that we'll create a PySpark script and we will run it on top of Hadoop. So what we will do is, we will just download our files. So I'll just save the required files on the Git repository. So as usual, we will just load the data in our Linux system and then we will just populate it into the SDFS by using some simple SDFS command, and then we can execute that file. So in this case, we will use yarn as a resource allocator and SDFS as a storage layer. So until that, just brush up your basics and I'll see you in the next lecture. So I hope you like this lecture. So please subscribe to our channel and also ring the notification bell to get the latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on our social media that I have linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.